Now we are doing the derivation for cantilever sheet pile. First case is your for granular soil. Now, as I said, there will be a point of rotation in case of granular soil for cantilever sheet piles. If this is my point of rotation O, the next stage, how this derivation has been derived, if I so this is acted upon by horizontal load H. Kp minus K line, this is your horizontal force, this is your horizontal force. If you look at this diagram, complete diagram, and now if I take it the original what I explained earlier, this is my cantilever wall and there will be like it is your dredge line. So, it says it will rotate. Some point at point O, this is called pivot point, acted upon by horizontal force. So, then as I said earlier, if it is rotated, if this cantilever wall is rotating at point O, so what will happen? The top part, if I divide into two parts, one is your above the point of rotation, other is your below the point of rotation. If I say above the point of rotation, this wall is moving away from soil. Suppose this is my soil mass. So, that means this part will be active, this is your passive state, and if you look at the bottom, it will be reverse. And this is your passive state, and this is your active state. So, generally, passive state we write Kp line, active state we write Ka line, or Ka we write it Ka. Now the same principle if I apply here, let us consider this is a cantilever sheet pile 1 and this is my dredge line and below this there is soil mass. Now this is a point O. Now above this dredge line there is nothing. So what will happen if this wall, cantilever sheet pile wall, now it will rotate at point O. It will rotate at point O. That means if it rotate at point O, what will happen? Above this, this is the passive state and this is the active state. Now I can draw, this is my Kp line. If I draw the passive earth pressure, it will be kind of like this, and active earth pressure, it will be kind of like this. So that means I have taken consideration of passive state and active state up to at point O. Now this is the passive line or passive state of the soil and this is the active state of soil. That means always remember Kp is greater than Ka. Passive state is greater than your active state, or passive earth pressure is greater than your active earth pressure. So that is why this triangle I have taken, this your Kp, that means passive state or passive earth pressure, it is bigger than this line is your, this triangle is your smaller, this is your active state. Now come back to, if this is your first diagram, second diagram, third and fourth diagram. Now come back to second diagram. In second diagram, what is supposed to be happen? This is my point O. This is the point O. Look at the point O. Below point O, what will happen? Below point O, this wall is moving towards, and this part is, it is, this wall is moving away. That means if I draw a line here somewhere else below this, this is your active state and this is your passive state. Now same concept has been applied here. If I draw it completely below point O, that means this is my active state or active earth pressure will act, this is passive earth pressure will act, and I will remove the pressure from O to dredge line, because the concept below this is different than the concept above your point O. Below this point O, it is different, passive state, active state. Above the point O, this is passive state and active state, this is in a reverse. So above point O, this has been neglected, and below point O, it is considered. So this will be your Ka line and this is your Kp line. Now for complete derivation, it has to be superimposed. Both the cases has to be superimposed. Now this has been superimposed. What happened? This is Kp and this is Ka. So this will be Kp minus Ka line, and this is your Kp and this is your Ka. In this case, this is your also Kp minus Ka line. So now the diagram has been drawn. So this point is your point O, this point is your point O. Now next question you can ask yourself, will it be the failure line? Will it be the failure line? No. Why? Because from passive state to active state, soil cannot transit in the all, sudden transition cannot be occur. Sudden transition means if you look at point O, if you look at point O, all of sudden it is in passive state, keep other side, then it is moving and it is changing, then all of sudden it is changing. So this transition is not acceptable. This transition is not acceptable. That means there will be a smooth transition from one state to other state. One state of failure to other state of failure, there should be a smooth transition. So that is why it has been drawn, so that it is slowly decreasing and it is achieving this other failure transition. So now this is your final failure mode of cantilever retaining wall below means in granular soil having a point of rotation O above the base. Now, how it looks? It looks like this. Now, these are the assumptions for particularly considering not nonlinear actual case of this, how it should be looks like. It should be a kind of curvilinear. It is a curvilinear, it has been approximated to simple straight line or maybe linear failure, you can say it. So, if I take it, this is my final failure surface, final failure surface of this cantilever retaining wall having embedded in granular soil. That means it is starting from one state to other state, there is a smooth transition. This concept has to be used for derivation of cantilever seat pile wall, for derivation of equation, that means what is the capacity of cantilever seat pile wall in granular soil. If I remove all 1, 2, 3, I am keeping only this part, final form of these equations. So, we will start this derivation, how the derivation has been made. Now, instead of suppose I say there might be a soil mass above the cantilever, there might not be a soil mass above the cantilever. As I said, cantilever seat pile walls are two types, one is your free cantilever, other is your simple cantilever pile, cantilever seat pile. In case of free cantilever, there is nothing. In case of, this is a typical case of free cantilever, so both the sides there is nothing. This stability will be achieved by means of your embedded depth. But the moment I say that cantilever seat pile, that means it has been embedded at one end, it will retain your soil mass. Now, if I modify this as only this is case of free cantilever, now I am saying that only cantilever seat pile wall, how it looks? This is the cantilever seat pile. Now, this is your dredge line. Now, it rotate. Like this. Now, here at this end, it is retaining soil because this is not a case of free cantilever seat pile. So, it is retaining the soil. Now, how the failure surface will be there? If I take this principle of this, look at this. This derivation of this failure surface below the dredge line for free cantilever seat wall has been taken. It has been put it here. Now, if you consider the top part as it is retaining the soil mass, it will generate active earth pressure up to this. Now, this is the final form of your, this is the final form of your soil mass, this is the final form of this failure surface of cantilever retaining cantilever seat pile wall. One side it retain your soil mass, one side it retain your soil mass. Now, you can say that with these conditions, what are the most adverse condition may occur while the derivation? The water table may be at the ground surface, may be somewhere else at the ground surface. So, there are conditions are there, but this failure surface, whatever we derived from free cantilever seat pile wall, that has been applied for your cantilever seat pile wall. Now, coming back to your complete derivation, if I draw it, this is the dredge line. Now, below this, let us say this is my point of rotation. Now, let us say at any distance below the surface, ground surface at the top, there is a water table. This is a symbol of water table. Now, I am drawing the pressure distribution diagram A, B, now this is your P A, this is the complete failure surface. How the derivation has to be done now? If I take it, this is my dredge line, this is the water table. So, let us say this property is gamma phi k p and k a, and below the water table the properties are, let us say, ek minute band karoge. So, this property I can write it, because water table is there, this will be gamma prime phi prime k p prime and k prime. Now, let us say this distance is h 1 and this distance H 2 and A B, let us say name D, this is point O, this is your C. Now, it will be acted upon by, let us say, a resultant force, this will be your P A, active earth pressure prime. Let us say all these forces, this is your resultant force R A, particularly from this to this, this is your resultant force R A. it acted upon by say, suppose say at a distance y bar from point O. Now, this distance say A, because why I am naming this derivation has to be made for this to find it out, what is the capacity, what load this wall can take. This is your distance A. Let us say from here to here, this is your distance y. Now, this to this, let us say y minus z, and this is your distance say z, this is your c. So, now if I put it like this, this to this, let us say it is p p prime, and this is your say p p 2 prime, and in between if I take it, this pressure distribution will go like this. So, in between from O to this, I say p p 1 prime. Now, this failure surface concept has been taken from, once again I am saying, from pre cantilever sheet pile to cantilever sheet pile wall, and this below this, whatever this free cantilever sheet pile, the failure surface it has been adopted, and this failure surface is drawn. Now, this I put it most adverse conditions, what may possible in most adverse condition may be possible during rainy season, may be this water table fluctuate from ground surface, from the below, from the dredge line, this water surface, water table may be raised to your ground surface. So, now, with this complete of this, what we are supposed to get? We are supposed to get what is the capacity and what distance d, what distance d, this is your complete distance d, means I should know depending upon the capacity how much depth, how much depth this cantilever sheet pile can be embedded below your dredge line, or can be put it below your dredge line. This is your output, this parameter to be required to find it out, as well as the capacity, as well as the capacity h, what capacity it can take, these two parameters to be find it out. So, k and k p is your Rankine earth pressure coefficient. So, let us start with this p a for this diagram, for this diagram complete. If you look at this, for this diagram this is your p a prime. So, what is your p a prime? P a prime is your active earth pressure from a to up to your dredge line, active earth pressure from a to up to your dredge line. So, p a prime is equal to k a gamma h 1 plus k a prime gamma prime h 2. Now, what is your p p prime? P p prime is your effective passive earth pressure at the base of pile, effective passive earth pressure at the base of the pile, this is your p p prime, which is equal to gamma prime k p prime minus k prime into y. Basically, earth pressure is your gamma either k a, if you look at how the derivation, your earth pressure will be your k a k gamma h, h is your distance, gamma is your unit weight of soil, and k should be either k a or k p. From this concept it has come here, because water table is lying here below this, this will be a submerged unit weight, that is why it is gamma prime. K p prime is your k p prime minus k a prime, as I derived here, this is a k p minus k a, and the distance will be your y. Now, it will be gamma prime k prime y. So, k prime is nothing but your k p prime minus k a prime, and k is equal to k p minus k a. Now, what is your p p 1? Passive earth pressure at point O, what is the value of p p 1? Now, p p 1 prime is equal to at point O, it will be gamma h 1 k p plus h 2 plus a gamma prime k p prime minus gamma prime a k a prime. So it will be your gamma h 1 k p, gamma h 1 k p this diagram plus gamma prime k p prime s 2 a, this is your s 2 plus a up to this, how much it is coming, minus gamma a prime a k a. If you look at a, this part will be your active state k a k p, and minus this is your active state because this part is also soil is there. So, this part will be active. So, gamma prime a k a prime. Now, similarly you can find it out p p 1 sorry p p 2 prime p p 2 prime, which is equal to nothing but p p 1 prime plus gamma prime k prime y, gamma prime k prime y, which is your gamma prime k prime and y is your this distance, it should be added. If the value of phi, remember if the value of phi for both the persons is same, for both the persons is same value of phi, phi value, then it will be k p is equal to k p is equal to k p prime and k a is equal to k a prime. Now, these are the values we get it p a, p a, p a prime, p p prime, p p 1 prime, p p 2 prime based on your earth pressure distribution diagram. Now, we have to find it out what is the resultant earth pressure, what is the resultant earth pressure. So, let us say R a is equal to resultant of all forces above point O, R a is equal to resultant of all forces above point O, above point O. The point O is located at a distance a below the your dredge line, point O is located at a distance a below your dredge line. So, now the pressure at point O is 0. Now, the pressure at point O is 0 with this concept, pressure at point O is equal to 0. With this concept, A gamma prime k p prime minus k a prime is equal to p a prime is equal to p a prime. Now, A you can find it out, the distance is equal to p a prime by gamma prime and k prime, k prime. Now, this distance z, now what are the other parameter, this distance z has to be find it out. Before finding out R a, this distance to be find it out in terms of k a and k p. Now, distance z you can find it out. So, distance z can be find it out, z you can get it by taking summation of force in horizontal direction is equal to 0. Now, R a, this force, this is acting in this direction, R a plus your p p prime p p 2 prime into z by 2 into z by 2. If you look at here p p 2 prime and p p prime into z by 2, this is a triangular distribution, this will act with a z by 2 plus minus p p dash minus p p dash minus p p dash, this is your p p dash minus p p dash y by 2 is equal to 0. From this you can find it out z is equal to pp prime y minus 2ra by pp prime plus pp 2 prime. Now, how many unknowns? There are two unknowns. You do not know z, you do not know ra. So, that means additional equation is required. That means you take movement at the bottom should be 0. So, taking movement at the bottom is equal to 0. Now, it will be r a y plus y prime plus z by 3 p p prime plus p p 2 prime into z by 2 minus p a prime y by 2 into y by 3 is equal to 0. That means I have considered there are two unknowns, two equations is required. One is your force in horizontal direction is equal to 0, other is your movement, taking movement at point but the base is equal to 0, then you can find it out what is the value of this. By simplifying this, you can find it out 6 r a y plus y bar plus z square p p prime plus p p 2 prime minus p p prime y square is equal to 0. Now, with this, putting this value of z, putting this value of z here to here, now this will be a fourth order differential equation will be derived. Now, this fourth order differential equation, if you write in a form, it will be y fourth plus y cube p p 1 prime by gamma prime k prime minus y square 8 r a by gamma prime k prime. Now, it will be minus gamma 6 r a by gamma prime k prime whole square into 2 y prime gamma prime k prime plus p p 1 prime minus 6 r a y prime p p prime plus 4 r a square by gamma prime k prime whole square is equal to 0. This is your final form of equation. This is your final form of equation in a fourth order differential equation, sorry, fourth order equation. It is not differential equation, it is a fourth order equation. So, how you can derive? It can be derived by means of trial and error method, by means of trial and error method. One end, you put these values, we put these values, then whether it is becoming 0 or not, satisfying or not, you see. First, what happened? You take a value, you see that whether it is negative or positive. Depending upon that, you take the second set value, then it will be, it has to be approximated. By means of trial and error method, you have to solve it. And with this solution, factor of safety can be provided by two methods. Once you get it d and r a value, you can provide your factor of safety. in by two methods. One is your the value of D obtained should be increased by 20 to 40%, or second factor of safety you can take it 1.5 factor of safety, 1.5 factor of safety you can take in Kp and or Ka. That means while designing at the end, what you are supposed to get? At end you are supposed to get the value of D. You are get at the end supposed to get your value of D, how much your depth D. So, how do you take the factor of safety? Either whatever you are getting the point D means distance D, this can be increased 20 to 40% for your factor of safety, or you can take 1.5 factor of safety in Kp and Ka. In Kp and Ka. We will solve a problem maybe next class.